Hello viewers, welcome all, and let us learn CRE. Now, in today's class, we're going to look at the Holy Spirit. We're going to look at who is the Holy Spirit and what is the role of the Holy Spirit. Now, this is a new topic that we need to give attention to, because this is going to give us an introduction to the CRE topics in Form 3. Welcome all, and let us learn. Your tutor today is Roger Muchira, who will be taking you through the CRE classes. Welcome all, and let us be ready to learn. Now class, what do you expect by the end of the lesson? We do expect that we are able to define who the Holy Spirit is, right? We get to define who the Holy Spirit is, and also get to discuss the role of the Holy Spirit as taught by Jesus, right? Now those are two things we're going to look at today by the end of the lesson. We ought to have known who the Holy Spirit is, and also we define the role of the Holy Spirit as taught by Jesus. Now class, can you get to know who the Holy Spirit is, right? But again, and again, I want to take you back. The Holy Spirit can be traced back to the times of creation, right? The Holy Spirit can always be traced back to the time of creation. Remember, the book of Genesis, we are being told that the Holy Spirit was hovering around, right? We are told that the Spirit of God was hovered around the waters before anything else was created. It is this Spirit that is responsible for putting into effect everything that God created. Now the Holy Spirit was hovering around, and it was responsible for anything that was created. Now, when again we come to the Christian doctrine, right? When we come to Christian doctrine, the Holy Spirit is in a Trinity state. Right? It is in a Trinity state. What do we mean by a Trinity state? Meaning that there are three persons in one God. Right? The Holy Trinity. In the Holy Trinity, that is where we have God the Father, good, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Good. That's what we mean by the Holy Trinity. Right? Three persons in God. God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Now, we have an image there. We can see God the Father, right? We can see God the Son, and also the Holy Spirit, right? That is the Holy Trinity, three persons in one. Good. That is the concept of the Christian doctrine of the Holy Spirit. Now, after we have looked at the concept of the Holy Spirit, who the Holy Spirit is, now we can clearly see the Holy Spirit is God, the Holy Spirit is Jesus, because it is three in one, the Holy Trinity. Now that we have looked at the concept of the Holy Spirit, can you get to look at what is the role of the Holy Spirit as taught by Jesus? Good. The role of the Holy Spirit as taught by Jesus. Now, one, the Holy Spirit teach Christians on daily basis the message of Jesus. Right? Remember, it's through the Holy Spirit we're getting to get the teachings of Jesus. Right? Remember, if it were not for the Holy Spirit, we were not to get the teachings of Jesus. Right? So the process of teaching is a continuous process. Right? We are still getting the teachings of Jesus through the Holy Spirit. And also, the Holy Spirit lives in the hearts of believers of Christ. Now, you cannot say you are a believer of Christ and you don't have the Holy Spirit. Right? So the Holy Spirit lives in the hearts of believers. It's the Holy Spirit that makes you believe. Right? Good. Then also, the Holy Spirit is an advocate, a counselor, an helper, and a comforter to those who love Jesus Christ and obey God's commandments. Right? Whenever you love Jesus Christ, whenever you obey God's commandments, the Holy Spirit will always be an advocate. Right? Will always be a counselor. We always be an helper. Look at the 12 disciples, right? What were they promised? That go and assemble in Jerusalem. I am going to send you an helper. Good? Because they believed in Jesus Christ. They loved in Jesus Christ. They loved Jesus Christ. They obeyed the God commandments. That is why Jesus sent the Holy Spirit, the Holy Spirit to the disciples. And also, class, the Holy Spirit will remind the disciples the words the words that were said by Jesus Christ, right? And introduce them to their deeper meanings. Remember, what Jesus was teaching, Jesus taught using parables, right? Now, remember, parables had a deeper meaning. So if the Holy Spirit was not into the disciples, they were not to understand the teachings of Jesus, because Jesus taught in parables. Now, and also, they interpret the deeper meaning of the message of Jesus Christ, good, reveal the truth and mysteries of and about God, good, affirm the right of Jesus as the Son of God. The Holy Spirit affirms Jesus as the Son of God. Look at during his baptism, right? Look at his transfiguration. This is my only Son, right? Trust in him. Good. That is the Holy Spirit that was revealing that Jesus is indeed the Son of God. Good. It also reveals the glory of Jesus' death. Reveal what is right and wrong. Remember, it's the Holy Spirit that gets to reveal that whatever you are doing is right and whatever you are doing is wrong. Right? You cannot you cannot reveal that. You cannot get to identify what you're doing is right or wrong if you don't have the aid of the Holy Spirit. Then finally, give courage to the disciples of Jesus and modern Christians to face persecution on the account of following Jesus. Remember, the disciples were persecuted. Those who are following Jesus, they were persecuted. Right? Now, this is the person who gave them courage, right, on the account of following Jesus. And lastly, the Holy Spirit enabled the disciples to expose the secret lives and heart of sinful people. Good. Look at Ananias and Sapphira, right? When they had cheated the Holy Spirit, right? Peter was able to know that Ananias and Sapphira have lied to the Holy Spirit. They have cheated the Holy Spirit, right? Because their tidings were not as per what they made. Good. Now the Holy Spirit was able to expose their secret lives and the heart of the sinful people. Right? That is the Holy Spirit that made Peter to know that, to reveal that these people have cheated the Holy Spirit. Now, class, we have looked at who the Holy Spirit is and also the role of the Holy Spirit. Now, for our task again, can we get to discuss the role of the Holy Spirit? Discuss the role of the Holy Spirit as taught by Jesus. And for reference, get to KLB, Secondary Christian Religious Education, Students Book 3, the 3rd edition. And as always, this is the Limit TV, your favorite learning channel, where we all get to watch and learn. And your teacher was Roger Michira, your CRE teacher. Thank you all for attending my lesson.